Electrum, plasma arc, a potent healing substance that goes back to ancient Egypt. Let's learn how to make this using the plasma arc. Now, the easy way to make electrum is to just use 14 karat gold. And that will get you about 70% of the way there, concentrations of the various metals that make up electrum. But the problem with plasma arc and 14 karat gold is it's unstable. And I haven't figured out why. Basically, I'll get maybe a week or two out of the substance. Sometimes only days before it just breaks apart and I have flakes falling down into the bottom. If you make electrum with low voltage electrolysis using 14 karat gold, it seems fairly stable. I have some stuff here for years that's still actually good. But for some reason, plasma arc breaks down. The advantage of plasma arc electrum is that it doesn't have anything in the liquid. It's just distilled water. Now, it can get extremely stable electrum when you use a laser. And that is actually my preferred way of making electrum. Is take some 14 karat gold, put it in the laser, and use that as a base to start my process, and then mix the little bit of ingredients that it's missing or is a little low on. There's one of the metals in electrum that is low on in 14 karat gold, but you can bring that up just by adding that metal separately to your electrum. It's not as good as cooking it all together, but it'll get you there. And that's with the laser. Now, with today's thing, we're going to take the individual metals and we're going to put them in the plasma arc setup. Here I have one of the metals and I have gold. And I'm going to plasma arc each of the metals that go into electrum with my gold right here. This is 24 karat gold. And that will give us the bonded molecule and put everything all together. Well, the timing is important because we don't want to overwhelm mixture. Basically, it's going to be about 5 to 7 minutes per metal in the plasma arc. And then you're going to turn it off and go on to the next one. Now, one of the metals in electrum I can't talk about. I can talk about the other ones. Gold, platinum, copper, zinc, and palladium. Palladium, I can't plasma arc palladium, but I can laser palladium. So later on, I'm going to add a little palladium laser to this mixture. The reason I'm doing it this way is because laser electrum takes hours and hours and hours to make because you're just making a very small amount at a time. Naturally, I can cook this in an hour. Under an hour, I can get 16 ounces of electrum. Whether it's better or not, I'm not sure, because here we're talking about 20 nanometers in size. And when we do it with the laser, we're looking at 5 nanometers in size. Generally speaking, the smaller the nanoparticles, the better it is for the absorption in the body. So, and that's one of the reasons why laser colloidals are clear, because their particle size is very small. So now we come to this situation here to make this. And whether this will be stable or not, this video is not going to answer. I'm only going to know that in a week or so or days. Each day I'll put it in the microscope to see if it's still together. But I wanted to show you the method, and you can certainly do this yourself on your own. Take the dissimilar metals. We have metal number one here, colloidal foobar, and we have metal number two here, gold. And this gold guy will stay here throughout the entire process. So now I'm going to turn on my 15,000 volts and apply it to this thing and see what happens. And I'm going to put my shades on. I got my gap just about where I need it. Going to start the timer. Here we go. Go for 7 minutes. Going to push down the pedal. And there we go. Got the arc is going. You can see that there. And what I do is I take the laser. So I put the laser beam in here. And this is a red laser. And you'll see there's practically nothing in here with the red laser. And after about 7 minutes, we're going to start to see a little bit of stuff in there. A lot of that is going to be from the foobar over here, metal I can't talk about, because that's the softer of the two metals. But we're only going to put that in there for 7 minutes. Through the whole process, we're going to have the gold is going to be bonded with all these other metals the way. So we're going to have the majority of it is going to be gold, which Electrum is between 60 and 80% gold and 20 to 40% of the other metals. I will be back in a few minutes. Okay, as you can see, the first metal is done. It's been 7 minutes, and with that first metal, now we move on to the other metals down the road. So we're going to remove this metal. The next metal we're going to use is going to be zinc. Put the shades on. Let's see if we got a spark. Start the timer up. Going to give it another 7 minutes. I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, we're all done with making the electrum. Just a couple notes on it. I like to use that metal that I can't mention, cobalt, first, because that has the hardest time creating a spark. And I like to use copper last, only because as you get more nanoparticles in there, the spark tends to decrease. And copper, we don't need a whole lot of copper. When you're done, it should look like this dusty gray, maybe with a little bit of a purplish color to it. But this is what it looks like on the microscope. And it's at least a 30 parts per million solution, could be even 40. Well, 50 parts per million, I find these... I'm interrupting the end of this video for a stability update. It's been about 5 days since I made that video, and the electrum has kind of fell apart a little bit since then. I had to filter it with the Buchner filter, and I would recommend that you do that with your electrum if you decide to make it this way, to get out the solids, because if you don't filter the solids out, they will actually act like a magnet and pull the nanoparticles apart. I think the stability issue comes down to the colloidal copper that's in there. And for some reason with the laser, the copper is not a problem. But the laser nanoparticles are highly stable no matter which ones I use. But in the case of the plasma arc copper can be unstable. Sometimes it lasts a few weeks. Sometimes they get a month out of it. It's more stable when it's mixed with other nanoparticles, but in this case, with the plasma arc combination, perhaps the copper is pulling the whole thing apart. Remove the copper? Sure, I could do that, but then it's not going to be real electrum. Electrum's got copper in it. So this is the way it is for now, and I'm going to keep tweaking the process to try and figure out how to make a 100% stable plasma arc electrum. But for now, I think this what I have here would probably be good for at least 3 weeks. And if you're making it at home for yourself, that's going to be fine. When it starts really falling apart, just throw it out and make yourself some more. I'm Tom, Alchemy Wizard. Have a great day.